Located in the Middle East, with bordering countries such as Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, and United Arab Emirates, it is the largest provider in the natural gas industry and oil industry. And that has made Qatar one of the most richest countries in the world. But this money has quickly been causing some problems to the citizens of Qatar. Such as 70% of the population is either obese or overweight via the cheap access to junk food and fast food, making Qatar the 11th most obese country overall and 6th obese country for males and 11th female most obese country for the female. Because of this fact, we have created a documentary. And in this documentary, we will be explaining why obesity in Qatar is an increasingly alarming problem towards the country. So without further ado, let's go ahead and meet our guests. Dhruv Margabu, Andrew Souza, Evan Jijo, and they'll be talking about the reasons why obesity has been a problem in Qatar.
Increasing rates of consumption lead to higher demands, which leads to the use of cheaper materials such as plastic. This harms the environment vastly, as the quantity released as a waste is much more immense. Therefore, we need to cut down even more trees for a livestock which produces even more methane. This butterfly effect affects us all greatly.
The higher incomes of people, the more viability to transport cars, which leads to less exercise, more pollution, and more manufacturing. People tend to work out less and use technology even more.
Eating fast food leads to addiction, which results in the rejection of healthier diet options. This risks the safety of many, many people. It endangers many, including you and your family. By eating fast foods, you are destroying your life and your purpose. I, as a human, do not wish this to happen at any cost.
We have talked about obesity and overweight problems. Why? Now I'm gonna go ahead and explain to you how you can lose weight and become less obese and then fall on some diets which can make you become fitter.
What do you think about obesity in Qatar and how is it affecting the people and their lifestyles?
Well, obesity was a growing issue, but now there have been things in place to create an environment where people are more active and more conscious of the active and health choices that they make. I feel like it's not as much of a problem as it used to be, but it's still something that we need to promote. Especially during Ramadan, people should still be making sure that they aren't overeating when they're breaking fast, perhaps.
And what do you think, there's still scope for, organizations from outside Qatar to come and help here? Do you think that's required, or do you think the Qatari government can handle it?
Perhaps looking at examples internationally could help, but I'm sure that they could put together campaigns themselves. I mean, we already have a sports day, which is, you know, a national holiday, which is dedicated to encouraging health and fitness. Maybe more focus could be put on healthy eating. Maybe that could be a new thing.
Okay, so Les, can you please tell us about your view on obesity in Qatar and how meat eating and meat consumption is a factor in this?
Okay, it is a huge concern here in Qatar. One of the things that we've been doing in MUN is trying to raise the profile of Global Goals number 3 regarding health and well-being. And it's really important that students and parents understand the importance of cutting down on meat consumption, particularly red meat. For example, in my family, we have gone to eating meat just on a weekend, and we try and eat vegetarian food now during the week in order to improve our intake of seeds and lentils and vegetables. And that's been brilliant. We've actually noticed a really a big improvement in how we feel. But all the offers on takeaways and how cheap McDonald's is makes the temptation to not cook there all the time. And I think for some people who perhaps don't have parents at home, or who don't know how to cook because we don't have home ec lessons here on how to cook and how to have a good diet, makes it very difficult for not just Qataris but for all people living here in Qatar.
So Miss, how do you think we can spread awareness to this on like a daily basis rather than just in one sort of meeting, for example sports day?
Maybe we could set some challenges, some meat-free challenges. I know the CAS students do some service projects on with cooking with Miss Usher. It would be really cool if that could be accommodated in the lower school as well. Perhaps if we could have some cookery lessons, or we could have a cook week where we can share recipe ideas perhaps with other people, your favourite non-meat dish, your favourite restaurants that do sell organic food, use recycled products. Those kind of things would be good, but it is hard and it needs to be something that involves the whole school community. So teachers, staff, parents and students need to be buying into this way of life.
Miss, and final question, do you think that going on a vegetarian diet will have the same effects, or do you think it's a healthier alternative to meat eating on a daily basis?
I think there are definitely merits to a vegetarian-based diet, but I do believe in choice. And I think, like all things, we eat in moderation. So if people wish to eat meat, then I think they need to buy meat that is locally and responsibly sourced. I've been quite shocked by how animals have been injected with hormones, or meat from chickens is made plump and look much more succulent than it is with water. So you need to make sure that you are looking at where your meat is, how the animals are treated. I think that's really important. But I don't think we should enforce a vegetarian based diet. I do think it should be choice.
Okay, thank you.
What do you think of the consumption of meat products and dairy products in Qatar?
I think the consumption is probably quite bad because the quality of the meat and the dairy products isn't particularly good here. So obviously you have massive issues in terms of porting now because of the blockade. And Qatar has now happened to start to learn to become independent. And the trouble is it's got a very short time period to become independent. So they've obviously made massive leap forward in terms of a dairy farm, but they're still very much playing catch up.
What do you think about the obesity in Qatar?
The obesity is really, really bad. It's not just with the Qatari nationals, if you look at most nationals out here. So unfortunately the summer temperatures aren't particularly good. If you look at a lot of the expats, we tend to do brunches. Again, it's just eat as much food as you can, short period of time. Again, exercising is not particularly good in this country either. Again, across all nationalities.
Interview.
Not only that, but more projection leads to more...
Stop! Affects us all. Great.